People think that 60,000 uprooted people is normal. In this country, it has never happened. Whether it be that Gujarat or 1984 violence in Delhi, or Gujarat thing, or anywhere, even the Pandits issue in Kashmir, it is not like this. And you try to push it under the carpet, and we make so much noise by the opposition. That's why they had to admit. They started doing things now. They said they formed committees, cabinet subcommittee after more than a year. Interestingly, after I announced that I'll form a committee to look into this matter, the government followed suit. It's very funny that way.
What went into that famous historic speech you made in the parliament, like the kind of preparations, the kind of mindset that
rose? I was waiting in the afternoon. They said I might get a chance in the evening, so I keep on postponing. Then somebody said that definitely you will get around 9. Okay. It went on, and I look up the watch, it's already 11:15, 11:30. Then I said, I'm going to speak because they said it's 12 and my number is going to come. I said, maybe I'll get 2 minutes, 3 minutes. And it struck me that Nehruji made that famous midnight speech. I thought that, okay, let me do this. And I felt a marginal sense increasingly that despite so much that I don't get a chance to speak, and it underscores where I stand as an MP, even as an MP from that part of the country, the marginality that you sense. And I said, let me be free and my people be free from that marginality. So I was thinking on that line, Nehru's speech was marking the freedom of the people, right? So I said, let my people in that part of the world no longer feel that they are nothing or at the periphery or at the margin of the national imagination. So I was thinking about that's why this phrase comes in. As the midnight hour approaches, I realize that this tells you the priority that you have. So that's how it went on. I was trying to tell, and I saw my colleagues from the opposition, from the treasury bands, started shouting, and I get them all worked up. Then I started screaming at them, just as they scream at me. You don't get to see that in the camera, though. There were certain things that they said. You didn't see me. There was a silence, and that camera turns to me. Then that's how you can see there's a difference between my first part and the later part when I was screaming at them. That's destiny. Just as Trace with Destiny, that was the destiny speech. I never planned it that way. Though I plan to say things like you have been excluding, that you don't visit, it's a continuity of the same marginality and all those things. I have a lot of examples. I was expecting that I might get around 15 minutes, then I would be able to put things in perspective, just as you felt today. For the rest of my own colleague parliamentarians and rest of the country must know, not only Manipur, but India's Northeast in general. That's what I started. Most of you must have done either in state board or NCRT, and you don't get to read about Northeast. So obviously it's blank in your mind, you don't know.
Right.
That's why I need to put them in perspective, what happens in the Northeast. And what happened in my home state is only an example, a reflection of that general outlook towards Northeast.